It was a storm of judgment. We had been hiding from oppression, hiding from Napoleon's spies, but now nature was washing away the disease. I always knew, as with all things built on the wrong foundations, the farm would one day crumble. At last, the wait was over. The poisonous cement which held Napoleon's evil dream together was being washed away. I could taste it in the water. I was old. I was almost blind, but I could still remember. It started the day the Pilkingtons returned Molly. Old Major, the prize boar, had had a dream. And the other pigs had called a meeting in the barn.
Now, boys, not too much.
Hush up, woman.
They shouldn't do that.
No.
They're having fun now, hush up.
Yes, we're only playing, Ma. And one day the pigs might come and play with you.
There you go again, talking rubbish. Only dumb animals. Run!
Boxer! Boxer, keep straight! Keep straight! Look where you're going! Boxer! Keep alive! Keep alive!
Ooh, the horse going the wrong way.
Jones, you old drunkard.
Miss Pilkington, missus, nice hat.
We brought your horse back.
Thanks.
All right, Worsie.
Molly?
Yeah, she did the job. Where do you want her?
You just
There's
her
a meeting
there.
Tonight. In the barn.
Okay, Jessie, I'll be there.
It's very kind of you to invite us tonight, Mr. Jones.
Oh, it's nothing special, just a few neighbours over for a drink.
Well, we wouldn't want to miss out on his generosity, would we?
Look, Mr. P, about your money...
My dear boy, we'll speak tonight, eh? Walk up!
Bye-bye, Jesse.
I hate him. He smells. Oh, do be quiet.
Come on, Molly. Come on. That man has loser written all over his face. I don't think he can take much more.
Are we nearly there?
I thought he was your friend.
My friend? How very little you know of the world.
Yes!
Yes! Come on, Boxer, walk on! Keep a line! Keep a line, damn you! Go on! Steady, Boxer! Boxer! Boxer!
pistol! Look what you've done to my field, you stupid lump of dog flesh! You're a dead old boxer, you're dog meat! You're for the glue factory! I'll hang you in my own house!
What's going on? Leave him be! Leave him be! Thou shalt not kill.
He was hurting Boxer.
But no animal can ever attack a human.
No human should ever hurt an animal.
Oh.
Where are you?
Jesse, go. Quick.
I've got a train to catch. Quick. She's coming. Quick. Wake up, you drunken pig!
We're now late, and the car probably won't start anyway. You said you got it fixed. Now, please, don't get drunk. There's a clean table for me covered. Don't wear those boots. And don't.
Hey, come on, girls. You're supposed to be at the meeting. Come on, follow me.
Oh, and the sink is blocked, and the butchery is full of lies.
Yeah.
Make sure you get Pilkington to lend you more money.
Animals, the wisest of us all has words which must now be spoken.
These words came to Old Major in a dream and must now be heard.
My friends, I do not think I will be with you for many days more. I've had a long life, and now it is my duty to pass on to you such as I understand of the nature of our lives. Animal kind is born to a miserable, laborious, and short existence. We are given only just enough food as will sustain the breath in our bodies for the work we do. And when our usefulness has come to an end, we are slaughtered with hideous cruelty.
No!
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 No! No!
Yes! And who, pray, is responsible for our suffering? Huh? Hmm? Man! Man is our enemy!
Mr. P. Oh, not too much now. Let's be trying to sweeten me up, eh?
Mr. P, about the money I owe you.
Yeah, my dear boy, just having a friendly drink. Don't want to spoil the occasion, do we?
The bank is on to me, Mr. P. I don't know what to do. I'm desperate.
Well, you could always just sign the farm over to me and have done with it, eh? Mr. Frederick.
I'm sure Mr. P will work something out for you, my dear.
Mrs. Jones not about this evening?
No, she's gone to her sister's on the train.
Remove man, and the root cause of hunger and overwork is abolished forever. Remove man, and the produce of our labor will be our own. Remove man, and overnight we will become free and equal.
Free and equal. Free and equal.
I thought I was free.
Will it mean no harnesses?
If you believe that, you'll believe anything.
We must never come to resemble man in any way.
If there are no humans, who will brush my mane?
Oh, no.
And who will braid it with ribbons?
Here, did I hear someone say ribbons? I could get ribbons. I could get anything. What you got to trade?
You shouldn't care about looking pretty for humans.
But I like looking pretty for humans.
Or engage in trade.
What? No trade?
Amongst us animals, there must be unity and comradeship. All animals are friends. All humans are enemies.
We'll have to stay over, Mr. J. Help me up, then.
Oh, beg pardon. Second door on the left. Oh, no. Mrs. P, you got the wrong room.
No, I haven't, my dear. Don't worry. He'll be out for the night.
Now, my friends, I will tell you about the end of my dream. And a song that came to me. It's a song you must learn. It's a song of justice and freedom.
Beasts of the world, we shall unite. Rise up and ready for the fight. Soon or late, the day will be when man's defeated and we are free. Soon or late, the day will be when man's defeated and we are free.
Oh, Mr. J.
Our limbs be tired and worn, our dreams will not be broken, and our hearts will not be torn.
Our dreams will not be broken,
and our hearts will not be torn.
What's going on?
Plastic
down.
Foxes.
Old Major had been hit. Was our revolution over before it had begun?
No. Oh, Major, no.
There are no rewards after death. There is only the here and now. We must work to make this life better.
Friends, we must always remember that old Major died for every one of us. And now, we each have a duty to him. Revolution!
Need feeding again.
Jesse! Jesse! Come on, girl! Come on, girl. Here. Take it. Here. Come on. Hello? What's the matter, girl? Don't like it?
If you paid more attention to the farm, we wouldn't have money troubles. Where are you going? The animals need feeding.
Just have to wait.
I'll let him rot. Now, come on, lads, let's get another train.
I need food.
Be quiet, Jack. Go stay.
Let's It's in the food store. Quiet. Boxer, we can help ourselves.
Come on. Come on, follow me.
This is an outrage.
On my farm, animals know their place.
Know their place? Of course they know their place. They're animals.
What am I going to do?
My dear boy, you're homeless. You've no money. The treatment of your animals has led them to seizing power, an uprising which could easily spread to all our farms. You've done enough. Shut up. I'm thinking.
Oh no!
He's gonna kill us!
Do something, Miss Pete.
Shoot!
And so at last, the farm belonged to us, and we were free. We knew we could live without fear. And Snowball would show us the way.
Can you read?
Not yet, but I will learn.
Oh, that's good. Snowball, the cows are in great pain. They need milking.
Well, I could try. All right, now just hold still. Whoops. Oh, Lord. All right, I just need practice.
Can you see anything?
Of course I can't see. I don't have the eyesight, do I?
Well, can you smell anything?
What? Other than you? Huh?
Hey, get off!
There's Snowball and Jessie.
Oh, I'm so sorry.
Hello, Jessie.
What's he doing up there?
Come here. Come and look. See, I have a glorious surprise.
What are you doing?
There.
Well, what does it say?
That is the farm's name. And as the farm now belongs to us, what words have I painted?
Us farm?
Animal farm.
Animal farm.
Well, if you can write, you must be able to read.
Yes, we pigs have taught ourselves to read and write.
What is it?
I think it's my time.
You're dying?
No, puppies.
Puppies? Puppies? Quick, what do we do?
Steady now, Boxer. Let's get Jesse back to the barn. Boxer! Boxer, where are you? Come on, we're waiting!
Are you sure you're okay?
Boxer, go with the others. I'll be fine.
If you're sure.
I'm sure.
Here, by the house!
What's that?
It's a box where humans watch humans.
Keeps them quiet.
Could be useful.
Animals, I propose that the farmhouse isn't used, but is preserved as a museum. All those in favor? Carried.
Let's see how the humans lived. They steeped themselves in luxury while we lived in squalor. The horsehair chair. Animals have to die for humans to sit in comfort. And this bed filled with feathers plucked from animals.
Sake.
we must bury them all.
Pincher to meet me in the harness room.
Aye.
This might be a problem.
These are old Major's thoughts, the principles of animalism. We must always remember what he taught us.
What is important? Is that we must never come to resemble man in any way.
One, whatever goes upon two legs is an enemy. Two, whatever goes upon four legs or has wings is a friend.
After all, we are animals.
Three, no animal shall wear clothes. Four, no animal shall sleep in a bed.
We can no longer stoop to his level.
Five, no animal shall drink alcohol.
Or engage in trade.
Six, no animal shall kill any other animal.
Fighting each other is the nature of man.
Ah, Pincher, sit down.
And most importantly, seven.
Amongst us animals, there must be unity and comradeship.
All animals are equal.
I swear on the sacred memory of old Major.
To serve Napoleon before all others.
To serve Napoleon before all others.
Rise up, Pincher. And take your position as leader of the Animal Guard. Bring in the other dogs.
This is the doctrine of Old Major, and it is our duty to follow each and every commandment.
Animals! Animals! We have work to do. There's been enough discussion. We have a harvest to bring in. And let us make it a point of honor to do it quicker than humankind. Now line up to receive your instructions.
Left a bit. Straight ahead now.
Ooh.
Right a bit.
Ooh.
Ooh. This is harder than it looks.
I must use all my strength.
We all worked together in the fields, and we were happy. The pigs stayed inside the barn and counted the hay.
Only 25 bales of hay today.
We need more effort.
I can work harder.
While Snowball worked towards Old Major's ideals, Napoleon made different plans.
And are the puppies weaned yet?
Nearly.
Well, we have milk to feed them. Take them away. Give us some explanation.
Animals, we are now ready to raise our flag of freedom.
Well done, Boxer. I give you the hoof and horn.
Told you we'd find him with his neck in a bottle. All over in 2 weeks, I think you said, 2 months ago.
This is what happens when a weak man is allowed to run a farm. On my farm, there are no weak men.
Obviously, the animals are managing better than we expected. We'll have to do something.
I'll do something. I'll wring his drunken throat!
We need information on what's going on.
Why don't you send in a spy?
How can we send... No. But we could listen in.
So, from the beginning.
A, G, B, C.
No. All right, we'll leave that for now and go back to our discussion on animalism.
I first started to suspect that all was not right when my puppies were taken.
Do you understand? 4 legs good, 2 legs bad.
Yay!
That's animalism.
Napoleon, I want to see my puppies.
No, Jesse, you can't see your puppies.
But they're my
babies.
If
you were thinking clearly, then you would be pleased at the special education that we're going to give them. You surely don't want to disadvantage your own puppies. Do you?
No.
Good.
No, I don't.
Well, off you go, then.
They still need their mother.
Her sadness will spread to the other animals.
Not if we distract them.
Yeah.
Education is knowledge. And knowledge is power.
Well, the knowledge I'd like is who keeps stealing the milk and apples.
Yeah.
That's what I call knowledge. Share and share alike. Isn't that animalism? Well, where's our share?
Animals, please!
Who has the milk and apples? 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 Who has the milk and apples?
We pigs have them!
Oh.
I knew it.
Oh.
Let them calm down. Then Squealer can explain.
Thank you. Oh.
Back in the farmyard, it's lunchtime for the chickens. Chickens are also one of God's wonders on the farm. This mother hen is showing her young chicks how to scratch the ground and look for grain. God has given them a sharp bill so they will have no trouble picking up the bits of food. All of the farm animals need lots of water.
Well, of course we do.
Animals! Napoleon has arranged to have this television here for your enjoyment and relaxation. This, my friends, is animalism in practice. But it is also animalism for us pigs to have the milk and apples.
I'm off.
Where's he off to?
That doesn't sound fair to me. I love milk and apples. Well, we all do. Mind you, Napoleon's always right. I'll talk to Jessie. She'll explain.
Milk and apples feed the brain. And if our brains are not fed, then Jones would come back. Do any of you want to see Jones back?
No.
Good. Then for all our sakes, we will continue to drink the milk and eat the apples.
Out of this way. You see no grease, you smell no grease, you feel no grease with joy.
They won't let me see my puppies.
Where are they?
I don't know. Boxer, the pigs always tell us what to do, what to think.
We must have leaders.
But what if they're wrong?
Napoleon's never wrong.
Dear Boxer, he totally believed in Napoleon. He just wanted to do right.
What's this rubbish?
It's not rubbish. I've heard my animals sound like that. There's a pattern to it, like they're singing. Listen.
Yes, I've heard that sound.
It's a signal, a code, something. And it's spreading.
Four legs good, two legs bad.
We invade.
This is a nightmare.
It will only be a matter of time before the humans invade.
You think so?
Yes.
What do we do?
Defend ourselves, of course. This is my plan. It's as I thought. They're approaching from the top field. Send the signal.
What if they change direction?
Then we'll make another plan. Are all the animals in place?
They're in place.
This isn't going to work.
Flying party has taken off. Jesse's marshalling the sheep.
Good.
Stay up here. We'll be safe. Let Snowball lead the charge.
Charge!
Glorious victory is ours!
Well, if we can't beat them, we might have to join them.
Is he breathing?
I've killed him.
This is war. The only good human is a dead one.
I've no wish to take life, not even human life.
But he's all right.
Look, he's moving.
Animals. You were so brave today.
Yes, he was the bravest of us all. He's an animal hero first class.
No, there was no one braver than Snowball.
Snowball, Snowball, Snowball,
Snowball, Snowball, Snowball.
My friends, we are all heroes. And we will celebrate this decisive day every October with a march past our glorious flag and the firing of this gun. Our farm is now truly Animal Farm.
Napoleon, Napoleon, Napoleon!
Napoleon, 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 Napoleon!
Snowball continued to try to improve our lives and soon came up with a new scheme. We were called to a meeting.
My friends, surely you can see that Snowball's idea for a windmill is a waste of our labor.
Yeah. It's not a waste. Once built, it will ease our labors.
Yeah. Our efforts must be directed at feeding ourselves, arming ourselves, barricading our borders, and defending animalism.
Yeah. No, no, no! For animalism to prosper, we must convert all the animals on all the farms. We must send our pigeons out to spread the message of revolution!
Yes!
We will vote on it.
Yes!
All those in favor of Napoleon?
Yes! Yes!
And all those in favor of Snowball?
Yes! Yes!
Animals, think of the benefits of a windmill. Yes, it will be hard work to build, but once it's built, it could save us so much labor that we may have to work only 3 days a week. Now, all those in favor?
Yeah! Yeah.
You pig. Oh.
Snowball.
Puppies!
Puppies! Puppies, leave him! It's Snowball! Leave him!
My puppies had become Napoleon's servants. Snowball was banished, and Napoleon took control.
So mages,
friends!
What's he doing up there?
Snowball is a traitor and a criminal!
But he was a brave fighter.
Bravery is not enough. Loyalty is more important.
You see how clever Napoleon has been, my friend? Of course he's not against the windmill. In fact, it was his own idea. He opposed it to flush out Snowball for the traitor he is. Tactics, friends.
There will be no more meetings, no more endless debates. From now on, a special committee of pigs will decide all aspects of the farm.
No!
That's all right.
No, it's not.
Now, I will tell you of our plan for the windmill.
So began our toil.
It was a slow, laborious process. And we were watched at all times. It was Box's great strength that really made the difference. But each and every one of us played our part. And slowly, very slowly, the windmill began to take shape. And at night, we'd return home, weary and hungry.
Trade with animals.
Why not?
It's immoral.
It's business. It's my farm.
That farm has been in his family for generations.
Yes. And what's he done with it? Ruined it, that's what. Congratulations. You've actually managed to turn your father's prosperous farm into a debt-ridden, crumbling piece of rubbish. Very clever.
You can't talk to me like that.
Yes, I can. I can say something else as well. You're finished around here. Both of you. Washed up. Dead in the water. Are these words sinking in? Yes. I think they are.
That's strange. There's someone in the house. This isn't right. They're behaving like men.
Puppy, stop that! Stop it, I'm your mother now, stop it! Stop it!
Puppies, off to bed with you.
What are you doing here? This area's out of bounds.
Nothing. I was just walking and then the dogs came at me.
Have you seen anything of interest on your walk?
No. Nothing.
Get back to the barn.
Things were changing fast. And at night, we heard strange noises as Squealer altered the commandments.
With sheets.
You, Mr.
Napoleon.
Oh, Pilkington. Very pleased to, Splendid. Splendid.
We will go into the house.
Absolutely. After you, dear boy.
Dear boy. Dear boy.
Wonderful. A polka with a sense of humor.
Old Major's words no longer made any sense. The pigs were now living in the house. Napoleon was rarely seen. But a statue had been made in his honor and placed near the barn.
Today marks the beginning of a new direction for us. Animal Farm cannot exist in isolation. To improve our quality of life, to build the windmill, to feed ourselves, we need to trade.
Didn't old Major say we must never engage in trade?
It's always the same. What goes around comes around.
None of this need concern any of you. As your leader, I will shoulder the burden of trade myself.
The pigs dedicated to his memory, the place where old Major had fallen.
Our revolution continues, and all our actions will now be looked upon by the founder of our beliefs. Pincher! Only criminals would fear old Major's presence. Long live Animal Farm!
Long live Animal Farm! Long live Animal Farm! Long live Animal Farm!
Well, that's a tidy load of hay, Mr. Napoleon.
Dear boy.
You know, this could prove to be a very profitable arrangement. Between ourselves, Mr. N. You know, you can trust me. I mean, I never wanted to have anything to do with that invasion. That was all Frederick's and Jones's idea.
Jones is our enemy.
And I am your friend. Oh, got a bottle of whiskey for you. Token of my gratitude, eh? Just try this.
Dear boy.
Now, to business. There's a shortage of eggs in the market. They're fetching a very good price.
Now listen to me, there's something I have to tell you all. Mm-hmm. It's about the pigs. Mm-hmm. They are living in the house.
No.
Yes, and they're sleeping in the beds.
No.
No.
Now, it's against the commandment.
No animal shall sleep in a bed.
Yes, that's right. That's the
My friends, let me explain. As you know, we pigs are the brains of the farm, and we must have a quiet place to work in, for all your sakes. Surely you don't want your glorious leader to live in a sty? Of course not. And yes, we do sleep in beds. And why not? There's no ruling against beds. A pile of straw is a bed. Would you rob us of our sleep so that we're too tired to carry out our duties?
But the commandment...
What commandment? There was never a commandment against beds. Read it.
No animal shall sleep in a bed with sheets.
You see, it's a commandment against sheets. And we certainly don't sleep in sheets. Oh, no.
Napoleon is always right.
Exactly.
To convince the animals to buy those rusty old silos I couldn't get rid of. They haven't got a clue what they're doing.
Not only that, they built a windmill. We'll probably end up owning that as well as Jones's farm.
What about the hunger, Mr. Pilkington?
What hunger?
I've seen some of the animals. Flesh and bones.
They look all right to me.
Yes, but you're not seeing straight with all that trade you're doing, are you?
My dear boy, if the pigs prefer to deal with me, should I refuse?
The animals are starving, and it's not to your credit.
Same again all round. You're still here, then?
Come on, get it.
farm or the windmill. Let him try and get his hands on this now.
Ruined. Our spirits were at their lowest. But Napoleon seemed triumphant.
Do you know who is responsible for this? Do you know who has stolen the truck and blown up our windmill? Snowball! The arch criminal and traitor has destroyed our work of the last year. Animals. I pronounce the death sentence on Snowball! We will teach this traitor that he cannot undo our work so easily! The windmill will be rebuilt. Every day we will work, rain or shine, food or none. Long live the windmill!
Sir? So early?
I must get on. We've got to rebuild the windmill.
Decree number 6. Our leader pronounces that Beasts of the World was the song of the revolution, through which we expressed our longing for a better society. But as that society is now established, the song no longer has any meaning.
Boxer, please, come on, you'll hurt yourself.
I have to do this.
We have a new song that gives voice to our gratitude for all we have.
Beloved leader Napoleon, fearless, faithful guardian, proud and strong, protect us from the wrong. You will defend us with your lofty trotter. Pigs, our pigs, our pigs. There is no beast that's braver. They will not ever waver. They face the fight for right with might. Glorious, great and triumphant, gallant hero, resilient, proud and strong, protect us from the wrong. You will defend us with your lofty trotter. Pigs, our pigs, our pigs.
Food.
I'm sorry, Boxer, but I don't think we're going to get any.
We must have food. I'm so hungry.
Make way for our leader.
Our valiant leader, animal hero first class, and animal hero second class will now speak.
My friends, I have found out that the arch criminal, Snowball, is still visiting the farm.
Is he?
I haven't seen him.
Trodden seed beds. He has even blocked drains. Snowball sabotage is the reason for our shortage of food. But he must have inside help. Which of you is in league with him? I will find you out. The guilty will have nowhere to hide. Because of this sabotage, the hens will have to surrender their eggs for sale in the market.
That's murder!
You hens should welcome this sacrifice as your own special contribution to animalism.
Never! Never!
You dare defy our glorious leader?
Ah! will smash our eggs before giving them up.
Yeah, dead right.
All hens are criminals. No hen will be fed. Any animal seen giving food to a hen will be punished by death.
And so in the middle of the night, the hens sacrificed their eggs.
This is so wrong. What have we done?
To sleep, my friend. We're just moving some of Jones's camera equipment. You'll see the films later.
With efficiency and patriotism, the Animal Guard roots out enemies of the farm. There's no hiding place for Snowball's cohorts.
Don't make a noise. Let's go.
And there's no escape from justice as they go on trial for crimes against animalism in front of our impartial leader. Our commandments say, no animal shall kill any other animal.
Guilty!
Without cause.
What? No!
We have cause. Guilty! Guilty! Guilty!
Oh, no!
And now for other news.
Our leader, glorious and valiant Napoleon, was today awarded the highest medal of animalism.
The leader star, first class.
But before we close our transmission, let's hear some words of personal thanks for our glorious leader.
Thanks to our beloved Napoleon, I've laid 6 eggs in 5 days.
Thanks to the leadership of our beloved Napoleon, this grass tastes better than ever.
And until tomorrow, it's good night from me.
Good night.
I like whiskey.
The pigs were behaving more and more like Farmer Jones.
Oh, where's he gone? Glorious leader. And her fearful skull eyes.
Says he's dying.
So am I.
Napoleon didn't die, and neither did his taste for whiskey. Life was bleak, but nothing prepared us for what happened next. were on our way home when a duck brought us the news.
Jesse! Jesse! Boxer's fallen by the windmill! He's on his side!
Boxer? Go! Go and tell Napoleon! Hurry!
Up there! Just on the other side of that cloud lies the kingdom in the sky where no animal ever goes hungry! Say after me, I believe in the shukalums that
Boxer.
Grow on trees. I believe in the everlasting...
Get off him, you... Oh. Boxer. Boxer, what happened?
I can't breathe very well.
Shh, hush. Lie still. It'll be all right. You'll soon feel better.
You have enough stones here to finish the windmill. I think I may now be allowed to stop.
Yes, of course. You must stop.
I will enjoy my retirement.
If any animal deserves to rest, it's you, Boxer. Here, try to drink some water.
Yes, I will.
Any improvements, Our leader is going to make arrangements to have his most loyal worker treated in hospital.
Thank you.
Now, back to work.
But I don't think I should leave him. Boxer, it's time to go.
I'm very weak.
Listen, Boxer, you're going to be fine. You're going to the hospital and they'll make you better. Come on, you must use all your strength to get up.
Yes. It's difficult.
I know, my friend. But please, do it for me. Do it for all of us.
Yes. Yes, I'll try.
Quick! They're taking Boxer away! Come and say goodbye!
Somehow Boxer managed to summon up the last of his strength, and we watched as he entered the van. Something smelt wrong. It made us nervous.
Lock it up. Let's go.
No. No!
What's going on?
The words on the van.
S-E-T.
Horse slaughter. They're taking him to the glue factory.
No! Boxer, get out! Come on, help me, they're leaving! Boxer!
Boxer! Bring
him out! Boxer, get out, quick!
Get out!
Kick your way out! They're taking you to your death! Boxer! Boxer!
We called out desperately, but we heard him give up the struggle.
Profitable afternoon. Your share.
Buy whiskey with it.
It's expensive.
Use all the money.
Certainly, my friend.
I like whiskey.
I could have saved him.
Nobody can save any of us.
I could have.
How?
I'd found a place at the edge of the farm, a good place to hide. I should have taken him there, but I did nothing. I'll never forgive myself.
Well, you could put the wrong right.
Yeah. Yes, you're right.
Muriel won't last much longer, and there are others.
Then we must save them. We must leave this place with as many animals as we can.
That's it.
Forward. Forward in the name of the revolution. Long live Animal Farm. Long live our beloved Napoleon. Napoleon is always right. Those were his last words. Rumors. Some of you are saying that the van that took Boxer away was from the horse slaughterer. Surely you know our beloved leader better than that. The van was from the hospital, but had previously been the property of the slaughterer.
Mind your step. Come. That's right. Come on in. Up you come now. Ah, delighted to join you for a neighbourly drink. Aren't we, Mrs. P?
We certainly are.
What are they doing here?
That's right, my dear. Come round here. There. You sit here, okay? There we are. Nice and friendly, eh?
I've heard such a lot about you, Mr. N.
So, all getting along splendidly, eh? Oh, may I?
No, you can't.
Quiet!
You're letting him drink all our whiskey.
If you're not quiet, I'll stick you on the flagpole forever.
Uh-oh.
A toast. Allow me. I said to myself, first of all,
absolutely, dear boy.
Allow me to congratulate you on the keeping your lower animals in order.
Thank you.
You're an example to all farmers. I mean, well, let's face it, no animal suffered from working a little harder or eating a little less, did they? The present company excluded, of course. Another toast. To Animal Farm.
No, not Animal Farm. I have decided we should revert to our proper name of Manor Farm.
Oh. To Manor Farm, then. And our continued prosperity.
Absolutely, dear boy.
I can't tell the difference between them.
Read it to me.
All animals are equal, but some animals are more equal than others.
More equal than others? Come on. We should leave while we still can. I'll get the others.
Now we go to our leader's house, where earlier today a spontaneous demonstration took place. A grateful duck has written a new song for our beloved leader. And she's here joined by the chorus of the Animal Guard.
Pray to him, the font of all our wisdom, long to live, the ruler of our land, Napoleon, mighty leader, watching over us. Napoleon, mighty leader, watching over us.
Napoleon, mighty leader, watching
That this farm will now devote itself to the making of weapons, to the building of walls, to the protection of ourselves and our way of life. The revolution is over. All animals are now free!
Free. Life had been far from free in our hideout. Seasons came and went, and we waited. The years passed. We grew old, but we still waited. Waited for what surely must pass. Waited for Napoleon's cruelty and greed to bleed the farm to death. And now, with the coming of the storm, came the first signs that our wait was over. It was time for us to return to that place that had once been full of such hope. I wondered if anything was still alive. I knew in my heart that Napoleon had fallen, a victim of his own madness. But what of the others? After all we'd been through, I needed to believe there was still hope. This be the same place where old Major had spoken of his dream, where we had worked so hard for a better life. All that was left was a memory and the pain of the poor creatures who had suffered. My heart sank. But there are always survivors. Have now fallen. The scars have healed. And life goes on. And what of the future? There are new owners. We will not allow them to make the same mistakes. We will rebuild the farm. And now at last, we shall be free.